The demand for our product is given by the following demand function. D of Q equals negative Q squared minus 2Q plus 517, where Q is thousands of units sold, and D of Q is the price in dollars per unit. It's important that we recognize here that Q is in thousands. So part A, if 7,000 units are to be sold, what price should be charged? B, if the price of $374 is set for this item, how many units can you expect to sell? And C, at what value of Q does D of Q cross the Q axis? So for part A, 7,000 units are to be sold. This does not mean Q is equal to 7,000, because remember, Q is in thousands. And therefore, if the quantity is 7,000, that means Q would be equal to 7. So to find the price, we need to find D of 7. So we'd have negative and then 7 squared. Notice how the exponent of 2 is attached to the positive 7, not a negative 7. And then we have minus 2 times 7 plus 517. And now we'll go to the calculator. So we have negative and then in parentheses 7 raised to the second minus 2 times 7 plus 517. So this equals 454, which should be the price if 7,000 units are to be sold. B, if the price of $374 is set for this item, how many units can you expect to sell? So in this part, they're giving us D of Q of the price. We want to find Q, which means we want to solve the equation 374 equals negative Q squared minus 2Q plus 517. Because we have a quadratic equation, let's set this equal to 0 and see if we can factor it. Because we want the leading coefficient to be positive, let's go ahead and move these three terms to the left side by adding Q squared to both sides, adding 2Q to both sides, and subtracting 517 from both sides. This would give us the equation Q squared plus 2Q, and then 374 minus 517 would be negative 143, so we have minus 143 equals 0. Now see if this will factor. We'd have the factors of Q squared, which are Q and Q. We want the factors of negative 143 that add to positive 2. That's not an easy question to answer, but since 11 times 13 equals 143, we could have negative 11 times 13, or negative 13 times 11. Because we want the sum to be positive 2, we'll use the positive 13 and the negative 11. So this product equals 0 when Q plus 13 equals 0, or when Q minus 11 equals 0, which means Q equals negative 13, or Q equals positive 11. Remember, Q is the quantity in thousands, so we can't have a negative quantity. So our solution is Q equals 11, which represents 11,000 units, which means you can expect to sell 11,000 units if the price is $374. For part C, we're asked at what value of Q does D of Q cross the Q axis? Well, D of Q crosses the Q axis, or horizontal axis, when D of Q equals 0. So to find where D of Q equals 0, we'll substitute 0 for D of Q, giving us the equation 0 equals negative Q squared minus 2Q plus 517. Now to solve this equation, this is not factorable, so we'll have to use the quadratic formula given here, where A is equal to negative 1, B is equal to negative 2, and C is equal to 517. But there is one thing that we should notice here. Q represents the quantity in thousands, and we know Q can't be negative, so we're only looking for the Q-intercept in the first quadrant here, where Q would be positive. So using the quadratic formula, instead of x, we'll have q equals negative b, or negative negative 2, plus or minus the square root of b squared, that's negative 2 squared, minus 4 times a, which is negative 1, times c, which is 517, divided by 2 times a, or 2 times negative 1. So we have q equals positive 2 plus or minus the square root of, this is going to be 4 plus 2068, or 2072, divided by negative 2. Now again, we're looking for the positive value of q, and since our denominator is negative, if the numerator is also negative, we'd have a negative divided by a negative, which would give us the positive value of q that we're looking for. So the exact value of q we're looking for would be q equals 2 minus the square root of 2072 divided by negative 2. Now we're asked to round to 3 decimal places, so we're not going to simplify the square root. We'll go to the calculator now and get our decimal approximation. So our numerator in parentheses is 2 minus the square root of 2072, close parenthesis for the square root, another close parenthesis for the numerator, divided by negative 2. And again, we're using the minus here because this will make the numerator negative, and our denominator is also negative, which will give us a quotient that's positive. Rounding to 3 decimal places, notice how the 6 in the 4th decimal place indicates to round up, and because we have a 9 in the 3rd decimal place, this will round to 21.760. So D of Q crosses the Q axis at about 21.760. So to understand what this means, this is the value of Q where D of Q, the price, would be 0. So this is telling us that if the price was 0, the demand for the item would be not 21.760, because remember Q is in thousands, the demand would be approximately 21,760 units. Not that you'd ever set a price of 0, but if it was 0, this represents the demand from the market. I hope you found this helpful.